Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Warhammer 40k Inquisitor Martyr in another episode right now. And in the third episode with the close combat guy, actually, we won. So we won, we silenced all the guns, and I actually fell in love with the two-handed chainsword. Let us take a look how it's called. It's called Eviscerator, and it's actually amazing. Because of the two main spells, I really love them. Do you call it your spells, something like that? The Savage Assault and the Spinning Blow, both of them are really amazing. Especially the Savage Blow goes forward and does a cone effect area damage, which does amazing against the Space Marines, the Chaos Space Marines, and the demons and the bigger guys and everything that's behind. How it wields, anyhow, how it wields against machines, I'm not sure right now, but we are about to find out, I hope, in the next episode, or on this episode to be precise. And because of that, I love that one that much. As I started actually in the off crafting this item, the second one, and I hope it would be better because if you go to crafting, it can be between 12 and 18 attack, and we right now have 16, so I hope we go to the 18. And what we actually have to craft as well is a armor. If that rolls out to be good, I'm gonna craft a assault armor as well. Because if you take a look at this, we can actually craft, assault armor MK2 Mark II. We are going to craft that one, but that's not why are we here for. We want to go into another mission, and that is actually a thing what I'm asking myself. Was the last mission easier because it was on a small map? I don't know. I'm really not sure whether the the map type, size has any any influence on how hard the map is. Could it be? It doesn't sound good, actually. It doesn't sound right. Ah, anyhow, let's go on. Let's take the Chaos Threat mission, which is mission type, which is gonna be a purge on a small sized map. And threats are, again, as usual, cultists, I guess, Chaos Space Marines, stationary weapon, Nurgle cultists, Nurgle demons, and I hope this time, please give me a Nurgle engine, a dreadnought or a decimator. I wanna know how the 200 weapon rolls out against it, but anyhow, it does more damage, so it should be better. Alright, so we go to the background right now. Heretical investigators bearing the Inquisitionist stigmata of death must be terminated, and at an abandoned subsection, purgation teams sent to the site went missing, but not before their tormented scream were voxcasted. Oh, that sounds nasty, actually. Orders enter the den of devil and butcher them like they butchered the boundless godwill of mankind. Right, we have to exterminate, of course, all enemies, and let us take a look whether we can actually make it. I really love the two-handed chainsword, Iveski Keju, sorry, I can't really pronounce it, but I enjoy it immensely. In the end, just a little announcement, I still have 6 or 7 episodes, or even 8, with the heavy gunner, so they are going to be coming as well. So there is gonna be some heavy gunner gameplay, but for now, I'm actually, for a couple of episodes now, probably around 8, 9, 10, I will focus on this guy here, because I'm right now actually having insane fun with it. I'm gonna switch the weapon to that one here. Swing around. Swing around the Rosie. Come on, kill them all. Amazing. Down they go. Just go. Yeah, do I go in the big room? Yes, I'll have to actually in the end. At least give me two. Oh, cool, we are. Alright. So, there's the Chaos Engine here. So, we will in this episode actually going to see how the two-handed weapon wields against a Chaos Engine, a feared dreadnought. Throw the grenade there. Okay, it hit the dreadnought, of course. It hit where I wanted to have the grenade. I'm sometimes confused when you try to throw a grenade how it actually flies. Sometimes it flies in the radius you actually have, and sometimes, you know, he just throws it away, which I don't quite understand. Thank you for that amount of damage. I needed that against this fucker here. I'm jumping out because I don't wanna waste the inoculators by now. And the good thing is, at least with the purge missions, you do not have the demolition thing running, so you are actually not running out of time. And now, I know I don't wanna make this episode last forever, so don't worry. So I think I really have to take an inoculator right now. And swinging around. And then defuse thing. As there someone stated out in the chat, this game is so easy. Yes, at some points it really is easy, but I really think, at least I'm, you know, if maybe I'm the baddest player in the world, which could be actually, which could really be, but I think with this class it ain't that easy. So grenade in here, killing the last guy here. Okay, I hope that fight is not going to take forever. As you can see, I'm not doing the greatest amounts of damage against this guy. So maybe I just do that. Oh god, that's boring, man. Oh god, that's boring. Trying to at least get some suppression back, because we are actually overwhelmed, which ain't that good. Okay, at least give me over 60, alright. And now I hope he's not regenerated, which he probably is. No, good. So, god, that does just 40. I really have to think about taking that one or not, because it doesn't do the craziest amount of damage against him. I actually thought about giving him a ranged weapon, which I think I can, but I'm not sure whether I'm really gonna do it. There he goes, and what does he drop? Of course, a grav pistol. Alright. That brings me to a fact which I actually think I said in the first episode or in the last one. Good, inoculators and nades, that's amazing. Even though if I have to fight through the door afterwards. What I told in the last episode, that in the last or the episode before, please punch the door. Then I need to move the camera around to subsequently open the door. What I said in the last episode, I actually want to have the old view back. What I said in the last episode, oh god, how often did I say that? No, that I'm thinking about giving this guy a ranged weapon, but it doesn't feel like the like the close combat guy, then that's why I haven't gave him that ranged weapon by now. But I think it would at least at some points make the missions easier for me to prevail against those enemy masters here. cool. Or you just have to learn to use the skills in the right way. Like going in the middle of them and just do something like that. Down there. And that's what I really think. I think the swirl and the savage attack, they do pretty damn good against all kinds of enemies. So swing around again, please. And savage attack here. Okay, that wasn't what I wanted. But now I will jump into them, do something like that, take the inoculator here, because I can, and of course my phone is ringing right now. Thank you very much, I hope you do not hear it on the record too much. Oh, it's still ringing, I tried to mute the mic there, but they are relentless. So we are going to bullshit. I retreat. I just throw a grenade then here like that. Gone they are. Jump out of here. I actually could use an inoculator because we have plenty of them. I probably used it in the wrong time, but that's alright. We have enough. Come on, go down. How much do you hold up, man? And I threw a grenade, it didn't do anything great. And now, of course, I can't take my inoculator. What the hell? What a bad decision of me. And I wanted to jump out, but I couldn't do it. Not nice, not nice. Alright. Are we at the beginning again? No. I really need to be more careful with this guy. I think the heavy gunner played a little bit forgetful, and at least for me, this class, this rollout, this weaponry doesn't feel like it forgives so many mistakes. You really need to be careful, you know, when you take your inoculator, at which point. At least that's my, that's how it feels for me. And when and how you actually use his skills. At least that is the thing that it feels like. I press Q, man. Take the inoculator. So, skills, remove them. We take them as soon as they are available. Doing that. Swing. Savage attack here. Swing around, swing, and do that, and I really need to take a inoculator in order to get the suppression back like that. Swing around, doing this one, doing that one, channel skill. I'm just trying to get the timings right now. So again, that's the thing which makes it a little bit tricky against Nurgle or Chaos Engines, to be precise. Come on, I used to be good at that. Okay, gone there. Ah, did I... Oh. Did get a new chainsaw. Amazing. And thank you guys that you didn't attack and make the battle oh so harder. And that's a thing, right? Come on. But they are probably gonna be fixed, I hope, in a pretty damn soon, that it should be fixed soon. Alright, then we will go on. Two dreadnoughts already down, which I give you that, comparing with the heavy gunner, it takes loads more time. Yes, and if I think about it, that we have seen over half of the interior here, and we have just have so many enemies left to kill. It's see what there is going to come in the last room. I'm a little bit afraid, to be honest. Okay, that was a waste of the skill. That's it. Down here, let us wait a second. In order to get HP back and not waste a inoculator, although I guess I could have used one, but you have to think about the cooldown of the great. Oh god, what was that? You have to think about the cooldown of the inoculator as well, which has a 30 second cooldown. So I actually think if you wait and let your health point regenerate, it's I think faster than actually you know, take the inoculator and rate the cooldown to be over. So I couldn't have used it right now, and I had to use it actually. I really had to use it. Come on, savage blow here. Jump in here. Do the swing. Retreat again around the corner. So our grenade maybe back. Grenade in here. Do the swing. Kill it. Vicious blow. Let this dreadnought retreat. And I wanted to say Cybot. I have to get that out of my system. So there are actually plenty of enemies left, at least it seems like that. Oh come on, it takes ages again. At that point right now, I'm actually not sure whether it would be better to take the inoculator and not wait. No, I don't get it. Why does he retreat sometimes and right now he doesn't fucking retreat? I don't get it. At some periods with the heavy gunner guy, he was, you know, he's out of the room and suddenly, immediately, he falls back at a speed where you couldn't get him with the heavy bolter at least. And here he follows you through the whole complete complex. I don't get that. And that are things which annoy me. Did he just vanish? That would be awesome. At least if he can finish the mission, then it would be awesome. If you can't find him, that would not be that awesome. So there he is. I wanna kill this one. And I kill this one. Come on, go in close combat so I can do swing like that. And now I try to use my spells the correct way again, without wasting any cooldown whatsoever. Do that, swing. Great. Do that. One. We will swing now. Do that. Channel a little bit. Do the savage blow. Do that round. Take an inoculator again, because we can. We have many of them, which is good for us. And it even spills out blood there, which is funny actually. Do you see that? That looks so good, man. I like little things like that. So, taking the rest of him. Good lord, he's gone. And we got a greatsword, blue one. Let's take it. I think blue is not the best. It's pink. But let us take a look at it once we have finished the last 8 enemies. 7 enemies, I correct myself, which do remain here. And we do not need to go up there, but we can go through the last door here. And if I'm taking a look at my recording time, it at least feels like the episodes are a bit longer with this guy. I'm sorry for that. By now I can't change it because I do not wanna split these missions up in 10 minutes. And you know, I think that would be be dumb, because so they are a little bit longer, and I hope as we level this one up, they are going to be over a little bit more quicker. Alright, so difficulty was alright, gameplay wise I thought it was amazing. That is my solo opinion here. What do we have in here? A solo armor, let's say. Ah, it's not the right one, I think. So we got a Mark II one that we already have. Nice. The Great Sword, Mastercrafter. Nah. Well, isn't it the Great Sword actually two-handed and only 6 attack? I can't even believe to use that one against a heavy one, but it has the physical 100 ability. I'll just put it there. And just in order to check, I could him giving a weapon as well. A normal weapon. Think about that, mate. I really have to think about that, but it wouldn't feel right, at least in my little opinion. Okay. 14 attack. Come on. Okay, do you know what we are? Gonna take a look at that one. 4 defense. But anyhow, we will craft that one, because we'll need a new armor. Maybe that was all the mistake I've done in the other episodes. Well, we will find that out when we will use that. It's gonna be crafted in 40 minutes, so I will can't show it to you now, but I guess in the next one or the one afterwards, I'm gonna show you the armor we have crafted. Guys, sorry for the longer episode, but I didn't want to cut it, as I said before. I really thank you for watching this episode. We are level 7, awesome. And if you enjoyed this episode, please give me a thumbs up or even subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. Until then, have a nice day. Stay frosty.